Hi, let us understand about container commit. After starting a container from an image, I might do n number of configuration or customization. After doing the customization, I may want to create a new image from the change that I have done so that I can reuse it later. For that purpose, I will be using the commit option available within the container where I can create a new image from that specific container. Let us go ahead and do a small demo. For the demo purpose, I will start a sample container. Then I will be installing some softwares. For example, I will take Python 3.6, I will install, then I will be committing it. And after committing with a new image name, I will be creating a container and check whether the Python is available or not. Let me go ahead and create a container. Docker container run in the detached mode. Let me name the container as nginx-commit, and the port mapping, let me map the port 6081 of this particular host to the port 80 of the container, and I'm going to use the image nginx. The container will get created. Let me go ahead and list the container. Now I'm going to get into this specific container and execute the bash shell. So I'm going to use the exec command, docker container exec in the interactive mode, and a separate terminal will get started. Nginx-commit, and I will start the shell. I am into the shell. Now let me check whether Python installed in this particular container or not. Python 3-v. It's not able to identify the command. Let me go ahead and install Python. First thing first, I'm going to update the packages. Let me go ahead and upgrade all the available packages. Yes. Now, I'm going to install Python. So this will go ahead and do the installation of Python. Let me see. Yes. It's going to take a couple of minutes to download the entire content and do the installation of Python. The installation of Python is done. Let me go ahead and verify the version. Python 3-v. I am within the container. Now it's able to give me the version. That means the Python is installed. Let me go ahead and commit this particular container and create a new image. Docker container commit nginx-commit. This is the name of the container that we had created, and I'm going to give a name to the image, nginx with py, and I'll tag it as 1.0. So it's going to create a new image with this particular repository name and the tag, and that will have the Python installed on top of whatever the Docker file was used to create that specific image. So what happens? It will be having the nginx installed. On top of it, we are giving another instruction to install the Python. Now I'm going to get a new image after consolidating the base image plus the instructions were given as a part of the Docker file plus the additional changes that we made to the system. Let me go ahead and list the images available. Docker image ls. Yes, I do have the repository that I had provided, and it is tagged with the version 1. With this particular image, I am going to create a new container. Docker container run in the detached mode. Name, I'll give it as nginx with Python, and the port mapping, I'll go ahead and map it with 6091 to the port 80 of the container, and the name of the repository nginx_with_py, and it will have the tag 1.0. let me go ahead and check this specific container. Let me get into this container, Docker container exec in the interactive mode, that is dash I dash T, and then the name of the container, execute the bin and bash shell. The name of the container is nginx-py. That's what we had provided over here, and execute the bash shell. So I am into the container. Let me go ahead and execute the Python 3-v. I should get the version. So what did we do? We created a base container with Nginx installed. On top of it, we added Python to it. Then with that specific change, we committed the change into an image. And from that image, we created a new container. And the new container had the changes that we had earlier. So this will be useful to keep on building the new versions with the additional top-up or with the changes that we are doing with the base image or after installing the required components or the software, and I can create a new image and reuse them within the team.